Plants are more complex than what we think. Pollination is the process of transporting pollen from one plant's anther to another plant's stigma. For wind pollination to occur, plants have to have green or dull colored petals and either small or no petals present. Typically, anthers are on a long filament stretching into the air so that mass amounts of light, powdery pollen can be released. They also lack scent and nectar. Chiodia has a stigma and anther that protrudes, increasing the surface area for capturing pollen. Insects such as bees and butterflies assist in the pollination of plants. The shape of the flower may be restricting and certain types of adaptations are required to access the pollen. Buzz pollination involves a bee vibrating whilst holding onto the plant to obtain the pollen. This process is needed to pollinate plants such as the Hyperdia species. Animals such as the tiny honey possum, bats, and rodents can contribute to pollination. The tiny honey possum uses their long snouts to grasp the nectar present in Banksias. There are a variety of seed dispersal methods. Some seeds have features that are designed aerodynamically to travel long distances with the wind. The Casuarina has light and fine seeds which can be easily blown by the wind. Animals can carry some seeds long distances before they are dispersed. Some seeds have barbs or hooks that can hang onto animals' fur or feathers. It can also be dispersed when animals eat brightly colored fruit with indigestible seeds. They then deposit their excrements in a new area. This is possible for the lilypilly as it has colorful fruit which attracts birds. Fire dispersed seeds occur when a fire has destroyed a branch or the whole plant. Seeds are stored within the plant until it is killed off. The ovary in the eucalyptus fruit has 3 or 4 valves. Once the fruit dries and matures, it splits open. Heat produced from the fire rapidly opens the valves of the fruit that are in the canopies of the tree, and the seeds are dispersed. Some seeds require water to disperse their seeds small or long distances. This usually occurs with plants that grow near water or in it. Avicenna marina has seeds that are waterproof and buoyant so they can stay afloat and easily be dispersed by water. Some seeds reside in pods. Once they contract and dry out, it sends an explosive discharge of seeds at high speed. Achaia cultureformis can scatter seeds from about 2 meters from the parent plant. Asexual reproduction is the process of creating a new organism from one parent plant, allowing mitosis to occur. A sexcellular gamete is not required to reproduce. Vegetative reproduction involves creating a new individual from one parent. It has the same genetic composition or is simply cloned. Phragmites australis is a common reed amongst most aquatic environments that can spread quickly by suckering through their habitat. Apomixis is where a new individual has exactly the same genetic code to their parent. In some plants, like Themeda triandra, embryos inside the seeds can be produced. Budding is an unusual form of reproduction. It involves the growth of a new individual as an extension of its parent. Parent plant of the Hydra oligatus reproduces by growing bud-like substances on its body that eventually separates from the parent plant and grows as a new individual.